Hallelujah. Greeting people of God. Today it's a very beautiful day. And I want to speak today a topic about breaking the spirit of rejection. People of God, I want you to realize that in this world that we are living, we have various evil spirits that fight people's destiny, and unless you do something about it, or unless you have come to the knowledge about these evil spirits, you cannot be able to refuse them or to break them through prayer in the name of Jesus. Remember already, the Bible says in the book of Luke chapter number 9 verse number 1 and verse number 2 that authority has been given unto us. So, and you are given authority so that you can exercise it and so that you can use it for your benefit. Remember, the spirit of rejection itself is non-acceptance. It means that you are not being accepted. Rejection can occur in all the areas of a person, a place, or a country. So rejection, the spirit of rejection, or any form of rejection, can occur to a person, a place, or a country. There is a place that you can go, and that place is full of the energy of rejection. So you find that when you are in that place, you are experiencing a lot of rejection. You can go to a town, and in that town you find that instead of things going well for you there, you are experiencing extreme cases of non-acceptance. You can go to a country, and in that country you find that you are experiencing non-acceptance. You are not being accepted by the things in that country. May it be employment, may it be business, may it be marriage. You are facing non-acceptance. People of God, there is a person that you can join yourself with, and you end up losing whatever you have. Meaning that this person is being followed by the malady, or is being followed by the spirit of rejection. Whether this person knows it or not. So you need to do a background check. You need to do self-diagnosis. There is something we call self-diagnosis, whereby you look at yourself, you look about your life, you look about your family, you look about the things that are happening or occurring to you. People of God, you may experience rejection from one's family origin, a friend, a partner, and this can result to emotions, and they can be very, very painful. People of God, let us first of all look in the Bible. I want us to see what does the Bible talk about rejection. Remember, our teachings are merely based on biblical teachings, on biblical information. Psalms chapter number 27 verse number 10, we find a form of rejection. For my father and my mother have forsaken me, but the Lord will take me in. To be rejected is to be forsaken. The psalmist tells us that you can be even rejected at a family level. Rejection can begin even at the family background, and it can later come to produce. We have the fruit of rejection. Fruit of rejection may result to a very painful life experience. There are people that were rejected back at home. They ended up in the street. They ended up in prostitution. They ended up in child labor. They ended up in drug abuse. They ended up in early marriages. They ended up in early pregnancies that were unwanted. These are the bitter fruit of rejection. Just because somebody was rejected from home, this person went to do things that he or she could not have done if there was love in the family background. We have people that are suffering through diseases, sexually transmitted diseases, and all manner of things that if you try to trace back the root cause, it was family rejection. The psalmist says that even though the family member rejected you, God will take you in. I'm speaking to a viewer. Even though you have been rejected in any area of your life, God will take you in. Jesus will take you in. He'll give you a way out. Psalms chapter number 118, verse number 22. The Bible says, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Bible is using the analogy of the stone. Remember, the stone they are talking about, it is Jesus. He was rejected, but he became the cornerstone. Remember, the cornerstone is one of the things that supports the house from the foundation. People of God, it doesn't matter the kind of rejection that you have gone through. You are going to come out and you are going to be the pillar of that society, the pillar of that family, in the name of Jesus. The Lord has sent me to encourage you. It is not over until the Lord says it's over. People of God, rejection affects a person. It can damage our mood, causing anger and aggression. You find that out of rejection, you receive the spirit of anger, mood instability. You receive unwanted aggression. I know people that out of rejection, they have mental crisis. They have aggression. There are even demons that use that root of anger, that root of aggression, to enter into a person. And anytime they notice that you are passing through rejection, they know that we have a door to attack this person. So study about your life. Look at your life. If you see that you are experiencing any form of rejection, look for deliverance prayers, because there are demons that enter a person just by using that door. Rejection can affect a person by making that person to face automatic failure. Where others succeed easily, you face automatic failure. It's like automatic failure mechanism. Where others are succeeding very easily or with ease, you face automatic failure. That's why you need deliverance from the spirit of rejection, or from all manner of rejections. People of God, rejection can cause lateness in marriage. There are people that have grown old and they have not yet been married, but the root cause of their problem is rejection. They are being rejected in the area of marriage. People of God, I am praying for you that you may come to the knowledge of looking for self-deliverance. Be delivered from spirit of rejection in the area of marriage. Rejection can cause divorce. It can cause broken relationship. It can cause termination of jobs, termination of employment. Rejection can push away business partners and customers. Today, I'm making a prayer for you. If you are experiencing rejection in the area of job, business, journey, land, machines, up seeing people being rejected by machines anytime they have anything that uses an engine or a form of mechanism in order for it to work. It rejects them. I had cases of people being rejected by Saron equipment, computers. They cannot be able to print their CV. If they hold any electronic gadget, it fails to work. It's rejection. But after deliverance prayer, they were delivered. They could do and operate the equipment with ease. In the name of Jesus. You can have rejection in the area of the soil. Rejection in the area of the soil. This means that rad will reject you. If you try to own any piece of rad, it becomes impossible even though you have money. Sometimes you end up being conned. You end up losing your money. Rejection in the area of soil means that the place that you step in, it does not even accept you. But I'm making a prayer for you. Be delivered from the curses of the soil, from rejection in the area of soil. If you went to start a business in a place and the soil rejected you, you can be delivered. The soil can accept you back and you shall prosper in the name of Jesus. I have had instances in my deliverance sessions of people that when they plant crops, the crops do not make it. They don't grow. But in the neighbors surrounding, the crops grow. People of God, this is the high time. If you realize that you are passing through any form of rejection, go in deliverance prayer. Look for anointed men of or women of God to pray for you. And if you are in Kenya, come for your deliverance in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'll pray for you. I'll deliver you in the name of Jesus. Rejection can lead to suicide or suicidal thoughts. There are people that out of rejection, they begin to receive thoughts of committing suicide. Remember, it is the gateway for an enemy to enter. Be delivered from today from every form of suicidal thoughts in the name of Jesus. Any spirit of rejection that is causing suicidal thoughts, come out in the name of Jesus. When money rejects you, you enter into debt. You even lose money. There are people that are rejected even by money. When money is in their hands, it cannot help them. They end up into being spendthrift. They spend more than they need. Be delivered today in the name of Jesus. People of God, I'm not speaking these things in order to scare you, but I want you to realize that we have deliverance prayers in the name of Jesus, and you can be delivered. You can be set free. You can be a blessed person. You can be a favored person. Remember, there is freedom. John chapter number 8, verse number 36. That's our scripture theme in church. Whoever the Son of Man sets free, he or she is free indeed. Freedom from every cage of life, from every cage of rejection. In the name of Jesus. People of God, sources of rejection. You can experience rejection that is about your birth. The history of your birth. If you read the Bible in the book of Ezekiel, I'm talking about rejection at birth. Ezekiel chapter number 16, verse number 5. Let me begin. Ezekiel chapter number 16, verse number 1. And again the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, cause Jerusalem to know her abominations, and say, Thus says the Lord God unto Jerusalem, Thy birth and thy nativity is of the land of Canaan. Thy father was an Amorite, and thy mother was an Hittite. And as for thy nativity, in the day that you were born, thy navel was not cut, neither was thou washed with water to sapple thee. You are not sorted at all. None of the eye pitied thee. This is the history of birth. We see that there can be rejection just because of your birth history. The day that you are born, who received you? What did your father say when he saw you or she saw you at birth? Your mother, your father, your uncles. What did they say when they saw you at birth? Did they accept you? Did they reject you? If they rejected you at birth, that thing can be a root cause for your suffering throughout your lifetime. Remember what the Bible says about the story of Jephthah. 1 Chronicles chapter number 4. 1 Chronicles chapter number 4, verse number 10. And Jabez called, verse number 9. 1 Chronicles 4, verse number 9. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, Because I bear him with sorrow. This was rejection. It was a painful experience. Just because he was born with pain, the mother decided to name him Pain. And this affected the life of this man. People of God, I pray for you. If you have experienced rejection during your birth, you can be delivered. There are people that have suffered in the area of job, business, marriage, career, and all things that surround them just because of rejection that they received at birth point. You can even receive rejection on the story of your conception. You find that the father or the mother is not happy with the pregnancy or the news about the conception. And this thing follows the child throughout their life. And that child might be a grown-up right now. There are people that even faced attempted abortion, but by grace they were never it was not complete abortion. This thing can follow a child even unto old age. Refuse any form of rejection, whether it was at conception. When your father told the mother that you have been conceived, how did they receive that news? It can affect you. People of God, we have rejection that comes through family altars. If you come from a family that has been rejected, the ancestor of that family was rejected by the clan, was rejected by the other family members, then you experience a lot of rejection, and it can pass from one generation to another. So retrace back your family. No. If I'm experiencing rejection in the area of job, business, career, or any area, is it in my family? My grandfather, my grandmother, my auntie, my uncle that I'm being named after them? Do they experience this rejection? People of God, rejection can come through curses. Curses are negative ones, and they can be able to run in families. There are people that have been rejected just because there is a curse that is running in the family. Somebody cursed your ancestor, your grandfather, your grandmother, or your parent, and this curse was strong enough to even come unto the next generation. May the Lord deliver you today. May the Lord set you free. May the Lord give you a way out in the name of Jesus. There are even rejection that comes through demons. For example, there are people that are facing rejection in the area of marriage, and this rejection was brought about by demons. For example, sex demons, they attract rejection in the area of marriage. If a lady at night you have spiritual aspect, or male demons try sleeping with you at night, these demons will cause rejection in the area of marriage. Potential marriage partners will reject you. Relationships will refuse you. If you are a man, you have spiritual wife sleeping with you at night, or female sex demons sleeping with you at night, they will make potential marriage partners to reject you. They will lead to relationships refusing you. You need to be delivered. You need to be set free from sex demons that cause rejection in the name of Jesus. And if any evil person sent a demon to you, and that demon has been sleeping with you, let it catch fire and come out in the name of Jesus. Come for deliverance prayer. Bad dreams can cause rejection. Come for deliverance prayer. Be delivered in the name of Jesus. People of God, bewitchment can cause rejection. Sorcery, witchcraft can cause rejection. Be delivered in the name of Jesus. Look for deliverance prayers. Breaking the laws of God or going against the will of God can cause rejection. There are people that experience rejection just because they did not obey what God told them to do. What Jesus told them to do, they did not obey. So they experience rejection. Retrace back. Did the Lord tell you to do this and you refused? Did the word of the Lord in the Bible speak this and you did the opposite? There are people that experience rejection just because they broke the commandment of do not kill. They committed abortion, they terminated pregnancy, and this brought about rejection. If family members commit abortion, it brings rejection in the area of prosperity for other kins or for other family members. Either they contributed the money or they did not. Avoid committing abortion. And if you committed abortion, look for deliverance prayer. Confess and you'll be prayed for. And you'll be set free. There is rejection that can come through covenanted properties, money, clothes, spells, and charms. Things that came to your hands, but these things they were spoken for to speak against you. Covenanted property. Properties that have come to you, they have spells and charms. They can bring rejection. Be delivered, and may the Lord reveal unto you these things that entered your life and they brought about rejection in the name of Jesus. People of God, you can be delivered. You deal with the rejection first of all by understanding the area of life that you have faced rejection. Then you begin to look for deliverance prayer, or you need to enter into a deliverance process. You can make a prayer in the Bible in line with the word of God. You can decree Romans chapter number 8 verse number 1. Therefore there is no condemnation for them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh but after the Spirit. You declare that. You know, rejection is a condemnation. For those of you that have visited the slaughterhouses where the butcheries go to pick the meat, we have condemnation pit, where if the meat is condemned by the health personnel, It cannot be eaten. It is thrown into the condemnation pit. Condemnation is a form of rejection. So you can decree no condemnation. I will not be condemned again. I will not be rejected again. In the name of Jesus. Romans chapter number 8, verse number 31. If God is for us, who can be against us? Romans 8, 31. If you know you are experiencing any form of rejection, decree that if God is on my side, nobody can be against me. In the name of Jesus. Jeremiah chapter number 30, verse number 17. The Bible says, I will restore health to you, and your wounds I will heal, declares the Lord, because you have called, they have called outcasts. The Lord is calling you, and he wants to restore back whatever has been taken away from you through this crisis of rejection. You can claim the favor of God in the name of Jesus. And as we continue attending deliverance prayers and being delivered, you'll be free. You'll be delivered in the name of Jesus. Let me pray for you. Repeat this prayer after me. Father, in the name of Jesus, deliver me from every area of rejection. Deliver me from rejection in the area of job, in the area of business, in the area of career, in the area of rad, in the area of machines, in every area of my destiny. Deliver me today, Jesus. Set me free in Jesus' name. Above all, look for a faithful servant of God to pray for you deliverance prayers in Jesus' name. You can write through the email on the screen, or you can call through the number on the screen, and I'll pray with you in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord do you good. I love you so much, and I'm praying with you in Jesus' name. Amen.